Hello, everyone, and welcome to today's webinar, Right Out of College, Right Into Your Mortgage Career. My name is Stephanie Sislo, and I'm excited to be hosting this session today. In this webinar, we'll be talking all about the benefits of becoming an independent mortgage professional, the growing wholesale mortgage industry, why you don't need experience to get started, and some firsthand stories of those recently graduated in the industry. For those of you who may be unfamiliar with beamortgagebroker.com, we help connect individuals with professionals who will assist you to become or join a mortgage in, independent mortgage broker. Now I'm pleased to introduce our panel of mortgage experts, Vince Parlov and Colin Cavanaugh with United Wholesale Mortgage and Ryan Rosati with Fieldstone First Mortgage. I have a few housekeeping items to cover. The recording will be available on demand after the live session. We'll send you a link via email after the webinar if you want to listen to it again or share it with others. If you have any questions for our experts, please feel free to send it through the Q&A feature, or you can email us at info@beamortgagebroker.com and we will reach out to you after the webinar. Now I'm going to hand things off to Vince to kick this webinar off.
Hey, good morning, everybody. Good afternoon. I just want to take a second and just tell you guys how happy I am to be doing this today with two fine individuals that I know personally and have watched both of these guys grow in the industry and grow as not as only professionals but grow personally as well by using the independent mortgage broker world. So as Stephanie said, I got Colin and Ryan Rosati here today. And really looking forward to, really using this as a launching pad to really show just how easy it is to get into the independent mortgage broker world. And not only that, but, really, I say easy at the same time. Everything comes with trials and tribulations and ups and downs and, and hard work and grit and, and failing and, and then succeeding and then, getting a bunch of wins in a row. And, today it's my goal to maybe, share these stories, personal stories with these guys and their journey of where they're at and what's going on, just to show you that it's real and that's what's going on. So, without further ado, I really want to, jump in and introduce my, my two guests today, Colin Cavanaugh and Ryan Rosati. I think today we're going to start out with Colin Cavanaugh. Colin, welcome today. Really appreciate you taking the time today. So let's jump in and maybe you can kind of give people a little bit of background about yourself and how you got here and we can start from there. So
yeah, well, thank you, Vince. It's a pleasure to be here. I'm really happy and obviously to give my little background and how I can help some other people with this as well. So basically, my introduction to the mortgage industry was from my mother. She was a loan officer, and so I was always around like the mortgage industry when I was younger, and learning like little bits and pieces, got to shadow her. And so really I didn't pick up on it until like my junior year of college when I actually came to UWM as a summer team member, and that's where I met Vince and kind of showed me the ropes of wholesale development. I got to learn so much through him and the benefits of being a broker, and I really wanted to be on the other side of it as well and help all these brokers grow their business, stuff like that. And a real big part of that was me playing soccer in college is I learned a lot of the skills that I had in terms of the business world and the excitement and really just the time management skills and the ever-changing mortgage industry. It's always interesting. And I knew through playing college soccer that I wasn't just going to be like satisfied with just an industry that's not too much. Just the mortgage industry is just ever-changing and always keeping it interesting. So I love my job as an account executive here to help a lot of people.
Yeah, that's awesome, Colin. That's a great introduction. I think there's going to be a common thread, and we'll get to this right out. I'm going to let Ryan jump in here and kind of give his introduction real quick, and then we'll get into some questions and kind of get into the flow of the webinar. So, Ryan Rosati, take it from here, my friend.
All right. Thank you, Vince. Thank you, Colin. It's definitely exciting, Colin, to hear where you came from, obviously, because we're both young, both in the industry. But as they said, my name is Ryan Rosati. I'm 26 years old. I'm the owner of Fieldstone First Mortgage. Have owned Fieldstone First Mortgage for about 3 years now. It's been, an incredible journey for the last 3 years, getting the chance to own my own business, be my own boss. It's been very exciting, but, I'm really happy that everybody's here to listen to this today because like most college students, you know, there's a lot of confusion as to what you want to do with your future, what that's going to look like. You know, they send you in when you're 18 and they say, hey, figure out what you want to do for the rest of your life. And that can be fairly difficult. And so, you know, I had those same struggles, but I was lucky enough to end up getting some internships in college that pushed me in the direction of the mortgage industry. I actually held the same role Colin did for a while. And, you know, I learned quite a few things in that role. I learned that a lot of the mortgage brokers who were out there in the world, they were getting a little bit older. There was a reluctance to use a lot of the technology, the reluctance to put themselves on Google, a reluctance to have Facebook pages, social media pages, and use a lot of technology that mortgage brokers in today's world are finally starting to use. And especially with millennials becoming the largest category of homeowners, that's something we're used to, right? It's even somebody like me, I can go on Amazon, I can, you know, get a package delivered to me the next day. I want my mortgage experience to be somewhat similar. And that's something we've been able to capitalize on. And I'm excited to share a little bit more with you about that today.
That's awesome, Ryan. You know, I mentioned earlier, and I'm going to come right back to you, Ryan, with this question, you know, kind of, and then have Colin weigh in. You know, one of the things that I see in individuals that are successful is coming from a student athlete platform. Maybe talk about that just for a second, how maybe that helped you. And it doesn't necessarily have to be that way. You know, some people work a full-time job and go to school. Some people, you know, got to take care of their parents and things of that nature. But I think it comes from the mindset that it's two full-time jobs being a student athlete, right? And that prepares you for the grind and the grit of, you know, whatever you decide to do, but you guys both chose the mortgage industry. So Ryan, maybe speak to that just real quick and how your journey was.
Yeah, so I got the chance for my first 2 years of school, of college. I played baseball for Rochester University on a small scholarship. And you are right in that it is, you know, two full-time jobs. You got to balance your 15 to 18 credit hours with, you know, 30 to 40 hours a week of baseball and of traveling and all of the above. And so going into getting a career for me, I really didn't ever want something where it was, I'm going to go into the office, I'm going to put 40 hours a weekend, and I'm going to know exactly what I'm going to make and, you know, exactly what the end of my career looked like. I wanted something where I could really challenge myself and where I could get out of it what I put into it. And that's really what the mortgage industry did for me. It allows you to, you know, go for any of the goals that you want to obtain instead of hitting that quote unquote glass ceiling. And so it's one of the things that really attracted me. You know, you have that competitive spirit. You really want to go for more, then I think this is a great industry for you.
Hey, that's great, Ryan. You know, that's, you know, I really appreciate the fact that you, you know, you took it, you know, from being a student athlete perspective, and Colin had, you know, kind of the same a journey in college. You know, Colin, maybe what you could do is, you know, also maybe wrap around you being a student athlete with maybe some of the, you know, what your parents were telling you, you know, about the mortgage industry and things of that nature, because you had that added kind of, you know, dimension, so to speak, you know, from your parents, both being in the industry, your dad more on the commercial side and your mom on the residential side, but maybe speak to that real quick.
Of course. Yeah. So I knew that mortgages were kind of something that I wanted to get into, and that's something that I talked to my mom a lot about. And I could see how hard she works to essentially give her clients the best experience. And also my dad on the other side, he helps grow small businesses with the commercial, being a commercial loan officer. So my job is kind of in the middle of that, I like to say, but especially being a student athlete, kind of tying that in together, very high energy. I've always been an extremely high energy person, not really like ever satisfied, I like to think, and just always just going for more. And especially being a student athlete, like Ryan said, the time management, balancing those two jobs, absolutely massive and really something that can carry over to the mortgage industry, because it's an ever-changing like industry, and it's extremely important to be adaptable and just be able to handle yourself. And really the time management part is the hugest thing for me.
Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, so you guys both come out of that, you know, really know both your families, you know what I mean? From that standpoint, to a certain degree, you know what I mean? Not extremely intimately, but, you know where you guys are, you know, the cloth that you guys are cut from, you know, so, you know, in saying that, you guys come from a great pedigree, right? Ryan, maybe, you know, talk about that for a second, you know, of what you saw, you know what I mean, behind the scenes as well, kind of like what Colin was mentioning of your dad, your uncle, and, you know, and what they did and kind of brought you to where you're at today.
Yeah, so you know, it's two sides of the coin, really. For my dad, he was a firefighter his whole life, and so he was the one going to work every not every day necessarily. Firefighter, they have unique shifts, right? But he was going to work for somebody else, and he did that all the time. But he knew what he was going to get out of it, right? And that was a very safe route, and he loved it, and it was great for our family. And then on the flip side, my uncle, now somebody else who's also in our business. He always owned his own business. And so I got to see his side of the coin. I got to see the flexibility he had. I got to see, you know, him obviously earn a lot of money from that business that he had. And so, you know, I got to kind of see the best of both worlds. And we all came together as a team when we wanted to start this brokerage. And so we had a lot of background, a lot of diversity and things that we felt that could make us successful. And, it has gone very well for us. And, you know, it's nice to grow up in an environment where you kind of get to see both sides of it. It helps you to make better decisions, I feel. And I'm lucky enough to obviously have those two in my life, and it's propelled us to a position that we're very happy with.
Yeah, you do come from two great humans there, the side that I know of them. Colin, can you speak to that just real quick, you know, maybe, you know, about your family and what was that is, maybe a little bit more.
Yeah, I mean, 100%. Like I said, my mom, so she was actually a retail loan officer, and the thing is about my grandparents as well. My grandpa actually owned his own broker shop, and so that's how she got into the business and really, like, in the industry. I got mortgage in my blood, I like to say, but and then especially with my dad being a commercial loan officer, and he really is has such a great relationship with all of his clients and really wants them to help them grow their business. And that's something that I took from both of them and that I really use on a day-to-day basis to try to help independent mortgage brokers grow their business as an account executive here and kind of be their caddy and help them along the way and always be a helping hand if they ever need it. And then obviously that's something that you do as well, Vince, but yeah. You're more in the weeds of it.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you know, it's, you guys both kind of, you know, you said the same thing, but then a little bit different because you guys come from, you know, two different kind of sides of what's going on. And I'm going to get to, you know, retail versus business to business in a second because I think there's a whole, you know, couple questions I have in regards to that. But, you know, you guys speak to, you know, they see Vince Barlow, you know, hosting this or whatever today, asking you guys some questions and things of that nature. But Ryan, if you had a college graduate in front of you right now and they said, and Colin, I'm going to ask you the same question here in a second and said, hey, Ryan, I'm thinking about getting into this business. I've heard a lot of seeing you're successful from afar. You know what I mean? And I'm thinking about getting into this business. Maybe what would that conversation, how would you frame that conversation to them of what to do and what maybe not to do?
Well, so first thing I'd say is I kind of want to go back to the previous question you asked, because you said, how did kind of your pedigree lead you to where you are? And I think it's important because me and Colin both come from different situations, right? Colin had family in this industry, so he was kind of, you know, he grew up to know this, right? On my side of it, I had two family members who now are with me who were in very different industries, right? And so I think that's the first thing that college graduates should know is that you don't have to grow up in the mortgage industry to end up getting involved in the mortgage industry. That's big. You can come in here, you can learn as an account executive, you can go get a job as a processor somewhere. There are so many different routes for you to learn and to understand this industry and still have success, even if you didn't grow up in it. But what I would tell a college graduate right now, and what I think is most important, that this is a career path you want to take. That's awesome. And there is a lot of upside that this industry has to offer. And one of those glass ceilings being, you know, shattered is the biggest thing, right? You have unlimited earning potential. You have flexibility. You have all these different things. But there needs to be also an understanding that it's going to take some time. You know, this first year of me starting this business was not easy, right? You know, I was making a little bit less than my friends and my family around me. And that hurt, especially coming out of college. You see your friends going on these elaborate trips and these vacations and so on and so forth. So there's definitely an early sacrifice, but what I would tell everybody is if you can stick with it, if you do the things that you know you're supposed to do to run a successful business, if you learn from others, then there's going to be more upside for you if you are willing to wait it out. And so that's the biggest thing I would say. And it's not going to be for everybody. It's going to be split, right? Some people are going to hear this today and say, I want nothing to do with that. And others are going to hear it and say, you know what? I love this. I want to be a part of this. And so just patience, take time. And, you know, I think that's the biggest thing.
Yeah. You know, that's great. You know, it's funny. I was just reading before I came in here, we got a printout of some people that are going through what you guys both noticed, the big program here. It's a college graduate program where we get people and put them in have them come around the whole company, right? In a 1 year platform, right? Where they go to each team here and they kind of see what goes on behind the scenes. there wasn't one person in there that said, I have my major is in mortgage lending. I mean, we had an archaeologist. We had a political science person. The types of degrees are endless. You know, you don't need a finance degree or a business degree or things of that nature. So, Colin, maybe answer the same question of what you would say, to somebody that says, hey, I'm thinking about getting into this business. And maybe give me a little flavor of, talking about that in regards to you don't need to be a math major, which is a common.
Yeah, thing. No, 100%.
Yeah, go ahead.
100%. You don't need to be a math major to get in the mortgage industry. What's really important is that you just have to be adaptable. Really just always learning, right? You have to, it's a difficult industry and you have to work really hard to make it in there, as Ryan has shown it with his success. So that's absolutely massive. And he's put in a lot of work to get where he is. And like he said, there's no glass ceiling in this industry. And the payoff is absolutely massive, as Ryan said as well. But if I talk to a college graduate right now, I would just say, 100%, I would recommend this to anybody with a can-do attitude, right? Just a positive attitude, really all you need to just approach every day. Ryan said as well, with being a student athlete, you have to have that attitude in order to be successful, right? So it's so important to just wake up every day ready to go, right? Ready to work those two jobs as a college athlete. And if you're ready in every day like that, then the mortgage industry would definitely be something that you should be interested in, because like he said, there's no glass ceiling or anything like that. And you get out what you put in. So I don't know if that answers your question, Vince.
No, it does. It does. It does in your way. That's what we want, right?
Yeah.
We want to hear about really how to get into it and figure it out. They don't. But we say around here all the time, have the hard work ethic and the right attitude, we'll show you the mortgage business. And it's not just UWM that can show you the mortgage business. There's all sorts of different paths and ways people have come to either here or, went out of here, started their own businesses and things of that nature. So, that being said, so I want to speak a little bit, because you guys both have a similar trajectory and then you kind of broke off. And let's just speak to that, Ryan. What kind of was your day, that you said, boy, I really want to go to the consumer's level, or just stumble on it, or, tell people that piece of your story.
Well, so I was lucky enough to be an account executive for about 2 years at a really good lender, right, who really helped me to grow and to understand. And, when you're an account executive, you're working with mortgage brokers every day, from New York to California, everywhere in between. And so you really get the advantage of picking up the things that work and the things that don't work, right? And I kind of stated this, I think, a little bit before, but, what I had found is that, the average age, and it's not all about age, but I think it kind of comes with the territory of most mortgage brokers were, roughly 55 or older. And so there was this giant market of millennials who's coming in who want to buy homes, and they want to buy it with people who are like them, right? And so I saw that as a tremendous opportunity to step away and take a shot at this. One of the unique parts about opening up a mortgage brokerage is you can start it with just one person. It doesn't have to be you hire on a whole team of 10 people. The overhead doesn't have to be crazy. So the barrier to entry was somewhat lower. And, about 2 months after I originally had the thought that this is what I wanted to do, I pulled the trigger on it. And, I wanted to emphasize a few things in owning this business. I wanted to make sure that we were really utilizing social media. I wanted to make sure that we were on Google getting good Google reviews and, making sure that our name was out there. I wanted to make sure that our clients had the ability to take applications online, that they were constantly in the loop. And so I wanted to do things a little bit different. I wanted to take all those strong points that I saw from brokers who I felt were doing things the right way, and then eliminate a lot of the things that I just didn't feel created success. And so being an account executive was huge for me and understanding what that was going to look like. I guess that was the biggest thing. I saw a tremendous opportunity for growth in that area. And, I always figured too, and I think this is something that also college graduates might want to hear, but, failing isn't the worst thing in the world. If you jump out and you take this chance for yourself and you fail, it's not the end of the world, right? You can go back and you can use that college degree. You can try a different path. And that's part of what all of this is maybe this doesn't end up being your path, but for me, I always wanted to be able to look back and say, hey, I took that chance, and if it didn't work, so be it. But if it does work, obviously, there's a lot of professional happiness that comes from that, and also a lot of personal happiness that comes from that as well.
Yeah, that's an awesome response. Colin, you had two parents that were really, you know, retail or to consumer. I mean, speak to this and why you found your passion on the business-to-business side.
Yeah, I mean, 100%. What Ryan said was fantastic. And when I got the opportunity to be a summer team member here at UWM, something that really took me by surprise was the culture and how we really got behind the broker community, right? Everybody here at UWM is leading towards the same goal, and that's to grow the wholesale channel by any means necessary, right? And just help all these small businesses grow and just grow to the extent that they want to be. And I really got behind that positive culture, and it's something that we really take to just every phone call, stuff like that. And, you know, I really enjoy it because I get to help somebody with their dream, right? I get to help them grow their business. They're calling me, asking me questions about our systems. I want to help them as much as I can. And that was the really important thing to me. And I love talking with all my brokers and really trying to help them as much as I possibly can to grow their business, to help them achieve their dream of being a successful mortgage broker. So that's where I'm coming from as well. And I definitely get that from my dad. In terms of the business-to-business sales and him being a commercial loan officer, it was just it was really unique watching him work with all of his clients. And it's not even clients; it's just friends at that point, right? They're like going out to dinner all the time and stopping in, saying hi. So I really like to try to take that same thing into every single phone call that I have with somebody that I'm working with, because they're our partners, right? And that's what I want to be for all of them.
Yeah,
and to touch on that really quick.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm sorry, but if you don't mind, it's funny, and I wanted to just add on to what Colin said, because he said a lot of them become friends, right? And that's the one thing I guess you don't really understand when you jump into this is, you know, by the end of some of these mortgage transactions, something that is would usually be stuffy and kind of mundane, a lot of these clients you even have, they do become your friends. They become people that you talk to on a regular basis that you stay in touch with. And you know, it's been incredible for me in relationship building and just seeing how fast spheres of influence can grow, how your network can grow. And that's been an absolutely awesome experience. That's one of the things that I've really liked about the business to consumer aspect.
Yeah. It's relationships, right? And if you're having fun mm-hmm. doing and talking to your friends and doing different stuff and people that folks that become friends, you know, that's a big piece of what's going on. So quick question, Colin, if there is one thing that you would do different, do more of, wouldn't do, speak to that just real quick. You know, give somebody one or two of those if you could.
Something I wouldn't do? I don't know. I wouldn't be hesitant to ask questions because the biggest thing right now is Vince is just a wealth of knowledge. And as Ryan and I have both seen, just have learned so much from him as well, and just learned about the mortgage industry. And that's something huge. Vince has had a huge impact on both of our lives in terms of that. So don't be hesitant to ask questions. I am constantly learning every single day in my job, and I'm sure that Ryan is as well. But just don't be afraid to really ask away and reach out to these people who are experts in the industry, because they have so much knowledge in the mortgage industry, and a lot of people have really seen it all. And everybody is really willing to help in this broker industry, because we like to think of it as just one big community. And there's websites like Brokers Are Better and AIM that really try to band together all these small broker shops to share best practices. So you're never really alone, as I'm sure Ryan will tell you as well.
Yeah, so now I'm going to get a bunch of hate mail. You know, you asked Colin that question and set him up from that standpoint. No, I'm just joking. You guys have done great in and of yourselves. You know, I've seen both you guys, you know, work, you know, not just for me, but, you know, you've used the tools that are around you and the people that are around you really to better your game. But, Ryan, you know, hey, listen, what would you do different? What would you do more of? What wouldn't you do? You know, any one of those, you take that.
You know, so I'm obviously really happy about where we are right now. And there's always things that you can do better. But I think one thing that I would have tried to stay away from more up front is when you go out on your own, you obviously have to start becoming financially independent, right? So that means you don't know when you're going to get paid and so on and so forth. And so there was always a propensity for me to get really down on myself if I wasn't working until 9:30, 10 o'clock at night. And it kind of had a negative impact on my mindset for a while. And, you know, that was something that has started to go away after time. And I think one of the things you can't ever forget when you're in this industry is that you still are a person, right? This is your full-time job, but there, you still have a life outside of it. So don't get down if you didn't get a loan that day, or don't get down if that lead that you had didn't work out the way you planned. It might not be because you didn't work till 9:30. It is what it is. You're going to lose some battles. Don't get too low when you lose those battles. Keep your head up, keep pushing forward, and your success will come. I think that's the biggest thing for me.
Yeah. And I think what you just touched on too is, you know, what I'm going to get to really to kind of, because we're getting ready, getting close here, you know, what's your mindset? So, you know, Colin, let's talk about mindset real quick. Is there something specifically mindset wise that really was an aha moment for you at some point during this process?
Oh yeah. And that's really for me is what Ryan said, right? Like there are lows, very low points in this industry that you have to overcome. And you really can't dwell on these things. It's every day is kind of a new day. I always like to say you're only as good as your last performance, right? So if I had a soccer game that I played amazing, next one I played terrible, I would be pretty upset with myself, right? Because I'm only as good as my last performance. So that's something that I take into every day. And I realize, like, hey, that day's over. Now I can move on to the next one. I'm just going to make this a great day and try to help my brokers as much as I possibly can and really do the best for myself that I possibly can. So that was a huge thing, just trying to overcome those lows in the mortgage industry, which do happen. And there's very highs as well, right? It's a very exciting mortgage industry, and there's just plenty of stuff to learn, and it's just ever-changing as well. So that's really my mindset comes every day. I really want to be a sponge and just try to learn everything that I possibly can. So that's really important to me, to just always have an open mind about things and really not get too down on yourself when you do have a bad day, because the next day could be the best day you've had in a while, something like that.
You got it. Ryan, your mindset?
Yeah, it's funny. Colin used the sports analogy because I played baseball, and so they always say in baseball you got to have a short memory, right? You can go out there, you can strike out two times in a row, but if you can go out there the next time, hit a double, triple, put your team ahead, then that's all that matters. You know, baseball, you hit 300 for a career, then you're in great shape. You're a Hall of Famer, even though that means that 7 out of 10 times you're not getting on base. And so I think that it's of vital importance, and it's going to touch on my last point, but it really is huge to not let yourself get too low. Even, you know, from my side of things, if I have a loan that's falling off the track, and you can only control what you can control, right? If you're putting all the pieces together, you're trying to do your best to make it happen, don't go to sleep with it. Don't let it hang over your head. Don't try to refresh your mind to come back the next day, be stronger, be better, learn from what happened the first time, and push through it. And that's really all you can do. Control what you can control. That's what I would say. It's the biggest thing.
That's awesome. That's awesome. That's really a good point. So I'm going to get to something fun here, you guys. Okay, so I know we got some questions that are probably going to go from here, but I really, you know, myself, as you know, I'm old. You know what I mean? Really old. I mean, I turned 89 years old this year in February. At the end of my day, you know, the bus picks me up and takes me back to the old folks' home, and, you know, and I get the, you know, cover up and then, you know, get by the fire and warm up. You know what I mean? What does Colin Kavanaugh do at the end of the day, or what's your week entail in regards? What do you do for fun, Colin?
Honestly, I like hanging out with my friends right now. I'm still staying active, especially after being a college athlete. I feel like can't let my body go too much now, because I'm just getting into that work world. But after I get off of work, I still take calls from clients, and I have absolutely no problem doing that, because obviously I have a great relationship with these clients that I work with, and I want them to succeed. So I'm always going to take a call outside of work hours. And if I can't solve it now, I'm going to call you and tell you I'm going to give you a call back the next morning, and really just go home, work out, and then go to sleep and get ready for the next day. Not much more to it, just the life of a recent college graduate, you know. So
awesome.
I'm still having fun, though.
That's cool. Ryan, how about you?
Yeah, so, you know, touch on what Colin said there. I think that part of this industry that's important is exercise can be pretty important. It's part of keeping your mind right. And so I think that that's something, if you wake up and do it every day, or, you know, do it at the end of the day, I think that's of vital importance. And then, you know, another thing he just mentioned was about taking calls after hours. And when you're in this job for long enough, you know, it doesn't necessarily feel like a job anymore. If somebody calls at 8:30 at night, it becomes, you know, this is, as we just talked about, almost like a friend, right? Like you're helping out a friend. So you're going to take that call and you're not going to care. It doesn't feel like work anymore. It doesn't feel like I'm clocking in or, you know, punching that clock. But, you know, I'd say what I do right now for fun and in my life is, I'm getting older too. I'm about to be 27 then. So I think I'm getting up there pretty close to you, but yeah, I know. Right. But one of the things I love to do, and 2020 has been a tough year for it. But I love to travel. I love to get out. And that's one of the things that this job has provided me. And in this time, being a mortgage broker, I've had the chance to go to Italy and Thailand and Vietnam and South Korea and, you know, places across the United States as well. And what's been so awesome about, you know, being your own boss to some extent is I can work wherever I have a computer. So even when I'm in these places, I pop out my laptop, I put 5-6 hours of hard work in, and maybe, you know, I come back from the day and I knock a couple other things out. And there's no asking anybody for PTO or making sure that I can get off or so on and so forth. And that's been a really awesome experience for me and something I plan to do and continue to do until, you know, eventually I settle down, get the family, the whole nine yards, where maybe it becomes a little bit more difficult. But at the end of the day, right now, that's what I love to do. And hopefully we can keep doing it. And 2021 will be back open for us.
You got it. All looking forward to 2021. Hey, guys, really, really appreciate both of you. I mean, there's a ton of value here. I think we showed everybody that we're all real. I mean, we still get up every morning, you know, you know, you got to strap them up and get to it, right? There's my buddy used to tell me, you know, he gets no pool money. That pool money is when you sit by a pool and people send you money. That just doesn't happen. It's never happened for me. never happened for him. But anyways, but appreciate both you guys. You're a success now. You'll continue to be a success. And it's been fun watching you guys and watching you guys grow. So with that, Stephanie, I'm going to kick it back to you.
All right. Thanks so much, guys. And thank you to our panel for sharing advice to recent college graduates. I'm sure so many of our listeners will be able to take these lessons into their own career. I know I definitely did. If you have any additional questions, please feel free to email us, or we will follow up with you if you had asked some questions in the Q&A feature. Our email is info@beamortgagebroker.com. As a reminder, if you would like more information on becoming an independent mortgage broker or joining one as a loan officer, please visit our website at beamortgagebroker.com for more resources to help you make the switch. Again, thank you to everyone in our panel who joined us today. Remember, you will be receiving an email with a webinar on demand soon. And thank you so much. Have a great rest of your day. Bye.